delicious hot cocoa. Hey everybody, what's going on? How you boys doing today? My name is Brandon and welcome back to the show. This is episode 18 and we've just been chilling in this local bar, you know, drinking a little hot cocoa, getting ready to go hit the slopes. We don't have any slopes on this island. I'm thinking we might need some skiing slopes down the line here. Maybe if we ice this whole entire lagoon off and then make some slopes right here. I don't know. Is that too small of a slope? I don't know. We'll figure something out. Don't you worry. Anyway, guys, welcome back. It's episode 18. That's right. Today we have a little bit of something special for you guys. You guys have been commenting so much in my videos, and not only in the videos, but on Reddit as well. And I wanted to kind of give you guys something back. So that's what we're going to be doing a little bit later today. But first, I gotta tell you some very, very bad news. So I decided to go ahead and start racing the turtles, which may sound like good news in the long run, but it actually wasn't. It turned out Sir Topham Hatt was like leading the race significantly. Like so much so that Rusty Saddle was literally at the starting line when Sir Topham Hatt was already at the underwater portion. Now, I had to do some research. I went ahead and looked up turtles on Wikipedia and figured out everything that there is to know about it. And though I still think I'm in the dark with the majority of what turtles have to offer, I did find one key piece of information that I think might make things difficult for us. It turns out that turtles have this mechanic where they try to get back to where they were born or their home beach. And the bad thing here is Sir Topham Hatt is from the far edge of the racetrack. So he's from off in this direction, right about here. So his main goal was to start off on the starting line and get back to his home base. So he just ended up right around here and didn't want to move anywhere else. Now, Rusty Saddle, on the other hand, he's from the biome right next to ours. So he had the opposite effect. Basically, he started off here, and because he is from right down here, he just ended up right here and just mingled and didn't want to move from here. Even if I got both turtles from the same area, like say I went back here and got another turtle from the same area that Sir Topham Hatt was at, the turtles still would have went right here and bundled up. And even if they decided to go do the underwater portion, they would have ended up here. There's no way in a million years that they would have backtracked back down the track back to the starting line. It's actually really disappointing because I thought this was a really cool and original idea. I've never seen anybody race turtles before, but it's not necessarily a lost cause because this is still very possible, but maybe not on this track. If I make a smaller racetrack over there, maybe starting here and ending over there where I picked up the turtles, and then I drag the turtles all the way up here to the starting line, then eventually we could race turtles back to their home. But that does seem like a lot of work, and I don't know if that would even look good having another racetrack all the way out there. Not to mention, I absolutely love this racetrack. This is a super sick track. You can see it all around the base, and I want to keep it. There's no reason to destroy it, even if it's just for looks, but I do want to get some use out of it. So I'm thinking, what if we get like every other animal that doesn't have home tracking abilities? Like turtles are a little bit wonky because they have that ability to try to get back to their home, but what about pigs? What about bunny rabbits, for example? Horses, you know? We could have different races that utilize their lack of AI, I guess. And we could race other things on this track. Unfortunately, I don't think turtles are gonna cut it. Anyway, now that we got that huge disappointment out of the way, and it's out in the air now, and I want to hear what you guys think, I think it's time to finally pay you guys back. Like I said before, you guys have been commenting like crazy, and you guys have been giving me so many good ideas. So today, I want to use those ideas in one big fancy episode. So let's go ahead and start building your comments. Oh no. Don't get me wrong, I am actually a little bit scared. The first comment of the day, Doza says, for the white quartz looking too bright on the Cocoa Lounge, maybe try bone blocks. Still white, but a little bit roughed up. First and foremost, I like the idea that this is a Cocoa Lounge, not a Cocoa Bar. That just makes it sound so much better. So Doza, let's go ahead and try that bone block. All right, you know, that actually looks super fancy. I don't know if it's worth going ahead and fixing it up on the house as well, because I like the house color. I like how vibrant and white it is. But the Cocoa Lounge, I feel like the bone blocks might actually be perfect. The brownish edges, the eggshell edges, kind of go along with this. Doza, I want to go ahead and give you a cha-ching good job on that comment, brother, because I think I like this a whole lot more than I like this. If I said you should make the floor ice so it's like you're sliding on the floor with socks, to which I responded, yes, I'm totally going to do a risky business bit.
Just take those old records.
That looked very bad. That was not good at all. I think it might have benefited to actually get my camera account on here. So responding to a post on Reddit that I made where I did this thing where I threw my boots out and then they were collected over here, Chippy Reddit responded, so do you give your chest piece to the man in the cloakroom too? This guy is totally a man in the cloakroom. So that's exactly what I wanted to do. I might not ever use this, but I think it'd be super fun to do. Just so it's like we have a full service, like, helper in this house. I'm so excited. I actually have a butler, guys. That's me, butler guy. So let's go ahead and put this trapdoor up right there, same place. And then let's go ahead and put hoppers into that chest and then into that guy. And then we'll just replace the carpet like that. So now when I come in, I'll go ahead and take my boots and my jacket off. So I'll take my jacket off because it's warm in here. It's nice and cozy. Oops, that's not where I wanted to throw it. I assume it goes to the right place. Yeah, we should throw our boots off here and we say, hey guy, thanks for taking our jacket. Appreciate it. And then we can walk into our building. I think that's very time inefficient, but I love the idea. Tricky, this is my least favorite comment. Tricky said, in the front of the hotel, we could use coral fans to decorate this like an actual lawn. Though I think this is a great idea secretly. I know there's no coral that I at least know of in the near future. So I guess we gotta go out and start looking for coral. I hate you, Tricky. I'm gonna have to travel like 5 million blocks in any direction and I probably won't find the dang thing. Absolutely hate you, Tricky, for giving me this medial and stupid task of getting coral fans. I am so freaking relieved that we found one so fast. I honestly thought I was gonna go a million blocks away just to find one, but it looks like all we had to do is go north a little bit. I brought these maps to show you guys kind of the path I took. Here's my base right here, and as I go up here, I did a nice little loop-de-loop and then up this way. And I ran out of maps. I only brought three because I didn't know how long it was going to be. But I ended up finding, like you can see this right here. This is the ocean biome right here. Literally right there is a coral biome. So I'm so freaking happy that we have one within reach. We hooked it up with another portal. So now we officially have a crap ton of coral. So my first go-to plan was to actually let the coral live. And I know there's ways of leaving the coral alive rather than letting it die. Like, for example, if I put this coral right there, eventually it'll die and turn gray and nasty. I thought it'd be super cool if we kept the original colors. We got reds, we got blues, we got yellows, we got greens and pinks and purples and so on and so forth. This kind of looks not bad, but blandish. There are ways of keeping this guy alive outside of water. It's super simple. All you have to do is waterlog like a half slab, for example. So if I replace this and put that half slab down right there, so this is a half slab, and then I waterlog that, you cannot see, but there is actually water underneath this block. Now, when I put some coral there, boom, it will never die. It will never die. So let's do this again with this one. Same thing works with the coral block. That'll never die. So I'm well aware of this trick, and I think it's a super awesome trick. Here's the bad news, boys. I'm working with ice, okay? So I got blue ice and regular ice, or packed ice, rather. And when I'm working with this palette, I can only use half slabs that match this. And the only slab blocks or stair blocks, you can do this with either or, by the way, slabs or stairs, that are somewhat blue are these prismarines. And if you guys don't know, look at this. It does not look natural. That looks natural, nothing like natural. Which is what I want to keep my front yard looking like. I want to make it look like basically there's grass growing. And if I do something like this, it's going to look like I have a pedestal underneath my coral. And that's not going to look too sick. So I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to leave them all gray and whatnot. That being said, this looks pretty good. I'm actually really happy about it, especially going up on multiple levels like this. Like, actually up on the house, you have some coral fans as well. That looks sick. You could even divvy up the design of it by adding some coral. Actually, I don't know what that's called. Like, fire coral, I think. Which looks hella sick. Even down here. Oh, wait. Those stay alive? Yeah, those stay alive because they're close to water, I guess. I do not like that. I'm just going to go ahead and break those. But you could even put coral up here on these logs here and make it look like it's kind of growing up these logs. I think, Tricky, this is a very good comment, and I very much appreciate it. Thank you! The next comment on our list comes from Doza. Snowmen melt in the rain. Did you guys know this? Because I absolutely didn't. So you got to make sure that there are no areas where raindrops are falling on them. Rip them. Next, build a cemetery. Ooh, you know what, Doza? That sounds pretty good, but I'm going to one-up you a little bit and say, maybe I'll give them a Viking burial, yeah? Don the Viking burial bow. Aim. Pull. I actually did it first shot. I honestly thought I wasn't going to do it. Aim. Pull. God. Aim. Pull. Oh, God. Pull. I did it. Yes. May you rest in peace, Snow Golems. Thank you for that, Doza. Very nice comment. We also got a comment from Bill Smith who says, I don't want to throw a wrench in your plans. Well, you freaking did, Bill. You freaking did. But Bill said that instead of filling up this lower part of the track with water, that we should actually have portions of the track that come up out of the water, but are domed and have water in them to add a water aspect for our turtles. But what Bill didn't understand, and he won't understand until he probably sees this video, is that turtles aren't gonna work because of what I said before. You remember the thing where they go back home and they won't be able to go? Yeah, anyway, moral of the story, I still think his idea is great and I wanna do something like that. But instead of going through a water portion because we're probably gonna be racing other animals, maybe we should just have it go through something else. So I'm thinking, let's go ahead and build a nice little building right here for this track to go through. Okay, Bill? Does that sound good with you, Bill? So we're starting to run out of concrete. We definitely need to go on one big mining expedition to try to get some gravel because we are just running extremely low. In fact, I ran out of yellow concrete powder, so we're not going to even be able to finish this build like I wanted to today. It's a little bit disappointing, but let's look at this cool looking building. As you come around this corner, as you come around the bend, you'll be greeted with this cool looking tunnel that goes straight through the building. I don't know what I want to do with this. I'm thinking about putting glass up here and then maybe like a mural. What if this is our map room? Oh. What if we put glass up right here, right? And then on the wall, we have just a ginormous map. Just a humongo mappo. Wouldn't that be super cool? Oh my gosh. Okay, well that's a project for another day. But let's go over to the front of the building here because I want to show you from the outside how it looks. You can kind of see a pattern. Can you guys see a pattern? That I'm basically using the same style building from this one and that one over there. Well, I hope you guys can because it's going to tie in this side of the island. Look at that. Look at that. It's going to look so beautiful, especially once we put the details in there, like windows and then half slabs and birch and all that stuff. Especially like this guy right here, there was too much green. So what I did is I divvied it up with this white concrete barrier here. So I think we might be able to do something similar to that. But like I said, you can see a pattern, okay? Because I'm copying the same color scheme as that, and I'm introducing it into this, okay? So it's the same thing because I want this island to all feel like the same island. So basically, this island, or this side of the island, is going to look just like that side of the island, and it's going to just tie everything in together. That being said, we might have too much of a good thing in the near future. You know that common thing, the too much of a good thing? Yeah, I think it's going to start looking pretty gross if we have too many of these buildings popping up. So we are going to have to divvy up what we build. That's why I think like the Coco Lounge was such a good different build, because it's a little bit of a different color and it kind of darkens up this little area right here. So we're going to have to think of more buildings like that down in the near future. But anyway, this is going to go ahead and call it for this build. Thank you, Bill Smith, for that super awesome comment. Next, we have Echo Song C4 saying that we should go ahead and put some sort of fact board. Is there zombies in my stuff here? Oh my, there is! Dude, no way. We're gonna have to light this bad boy up. Oh no, this is a problem. Oh wow, look at everything he dropped. Whoa. Okay guys, we're rich. Anyway, Echo Song C4 said that we should make a fact board. Because this is our bamboo producing building, we wanted to do something different in this building. And he thought it'd be a great idea. I also think it's gonna be a great idea to put facts on this board about bamboo. So I got a couple of facts for us. So the first fact is that bamboo is a type of grass. You know, grass is green, bamboo is green. This checks out. And did you know that bamboo is actually stronger than steel? So I brought my iron sword and I think they're lying to us. Bamboo also produces flowers at the same time each and every single year, which is super sick. This fact kind of makes me mad. Why didn't Minecraft put flowers on these bamboos? Oh, you missed out on a big opportunity there, Yimouyang. And last but not least, bamboo actually symbolizes a long life. Okay, that happened. Now I kind of just want to decorate this up a little bit because I know this is going to be super fancy. If we put some bamboo in some flower pots, look how freaking cool this is. Oh yeah, that looks beautiful. There will be more bamboo facts to come. I'm going to put some right here as well. It looks like we have room for 6 more over here and 2 more over here. Did we not center this? I don't think we centered this. I think it's fine. I think it'll look fine. Anyway, thank you, Echo Song, for giving us that comment. Mucho gracias. Now, last but certainly not least, our boy Echo Song C4 hits us again with another comment. In the last couple videos, I've been like, what are we going to do with this mountain thing here? And he commented saying that we should make this into an announcer slash commentator watchtower for the racetrack. And I think that is a beautiful idea. But rather than make you guys suffer through another time lapse of me building this thing, I think I'm going to do it while listening to some music or something. Maybe I'll put on some Pandora and listen to some country music while I build this thing and spare you guys another time lapse. So let's get started. And bam! Oh my goodness. It looks freaking beautiful. Obviously, there's some stuff we gotta do still. I wanna touch up these corner bits right there. From up there, it's kind of hard to see this bit of the track, so I had to break this white concrete just a tad bit so you can see kind of down. Another thing is I made this little, right there, there it is, that door right there. Well, it's not really a door, but that opening right there, I'm thinking about making a convertible switch so it switches soul sand to magna blocks. And then we put a water column going up and down. And then as well, we do need to make a cap to the watchtower, a little bit of a roof. But for now, I think this looks beautiful. We're running out of like concrete powder, and we're running out of everything, sand, gravel, everything you're gonna need to make more of this stuff. But this is looking super cool. I'm thinking making this mountain a little bit thicker, I guess. So it looks like it actually supports this watchtower, as well as putting trees and stuff off to the side so it doesn't look like, because right now, this kind of just looks plain and blah. I do want to put some more trees and stuff to fill this up, fill this area up a little bit, guys. But I think that's just about going to do it for me today. This is going to take a lot of editing for this video, but I am super happy, guys. I've never done a video like this before. One, because I've never had this much support on a series, so I can't tell you how awesome this makes me feel. Like, I'm running out of words to say because I love you guys so much. You've been giving me so much inspiration and so many ideas that this video wasn't even on the list of videos for me to do. I wrote down all the videos that I wanted to do. This one wasn't even on the list because I didn't think that this was going to be a possibility. So the fact that we're doing it right now, I gotta say thank you guys. Much love, seriously. You guys are freaking awesome. If you're new to the channel and you haven't subbed, consider it. Consider subscribing and commenting, because if I see your guys' faces in the comments below, I might be able to do another episode like this where I do your guys' builds. I don't know. What do you guys think? Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I love you guys so freaking much. I can't wait till next episode. Episode 19's next. Isn't that crazy? I think 20 we're going to fight the Ender Dragon. I think so. I think that's the plan. Anyway, guys, much love. Thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, what if I just didn't give an outro? 'Probably worth mentioning that Finacqua said that we should build some underwater stands so that we could view the race from the outside the track underwater. They didn't turn out too hot, and I don't like Fen, so there you go. I hate you, Fen.